Hi, this is Els from Els Winnebuck Studio for Elizabeth Craft Designs. In this YouTube, I would like to show you two different ways to use the Happy Birthday die from Away With Words from Suzanne Cannon for Elizabeth Craft Designs. So first I started with a 230 grams soft finish cardstock and I put that clear double-sided adhesive on top. You don't want to use too heavy cardstock because otherwise the die will not cut through all the way. So this is how I started. So I took a piece of clear double-sided adhesive, put it on the white cardstock, and then I run it through my Big Shot machine or Cuddlebug, any die cutting machine that uses the thin dies. Sometimes you need to use a metal adapter plate. I didn't in this case because it cut really beautifully, but it depending on your die cutting machine. So I run this through and then I had the happy birthday. So that's the die. And I'm going to use the Silk Microfine Glitter for that. So I'm going to take off that release sheet and I want to make sure that I keep that in one piece because I am going to reuse that. So I'm going to take that carefully off. I use the fine pointed tweezer and I'm using a other piece of release sheet because I don't want to touch the sticky before I glitter. So I'm just using that release sheet to hold that die. And I'm going to save this because I'm going to use that for the second card. So I'm going to put it aside. So now this one I want to have glittered in the teal microfine glitter. Okay, so I'm just going to sprinkle one side first. I'm not going to touch the tape with my fingers. Tap this off and now I can take this off and I save this again. And now I'm going to do the rest of the. And as you can see, I use a coffee filter. And I can sprinkle the whole thing. If I miss a little bit, I just dab it in here. Just make sure it doesn't touch the paper of the coffee filter. You see, and now I have this glittered. But with the Silk Microfine Glitter and our clear double-sided adhesive, it really starts to sparkle when you polish it. So I just put this back into the jar. And with the coffee filter, that just works easy. And then I'm going to tap it up over a paper bag. Because a paper bag is not static, so that really is easy to use as well. So that's the teal. Now I'm going to polish this. And you will see, and I don't know if the camera catches it, I will do the happy first. Yeah, and then you'll see that the happy really sparkles already and the birthday not that much. Because it's really the polishing that brings out the sparkle in the glitter, in the Silk Microfine Glitter. So I'm just going to polish this. So this is what I used for this card. The background for this card sits the white soft finish cardstock and I used a Ken Oliver Color Burst on that. Works really beautiful. And then the card itself is actually the colored soft finish cardstock. And the big advantage of that is it has a white core and it has a beautiful texture as well. So that's what I used for this. So it's a combination of the white soft finish cardstock and the colored soft finish cardstock and the Color Burst on the white soft finish cardstock. So that's the first card. And then I have this left, so I'm going to reuse that. So I have another piece of clear double-sided adhesive on the white cardstock. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to take this off, going to take the release sheet off, try not to touch the sticky. I'm going to put this aside for a second. Then I'm going to take my happy birthday and I'm going to put it on here. And I'm going to put it in an angle. And so this is just the release sheet. And I can use this over and over again. As long as this is in one piece, I can use it 100 times, doesn't matter. So you save this. So I make sure this is pressed down. And you see, I use a release sheet for that. Because you never want to touch the sticky. And I need to make sure it's pressed down here as well. So press it down really well. And then I'm going to do my outside collar first. And in this case, I'm going to use the teal. So check it, I think I'm good here. So I can use the release sheet, take this back, take my coffee filter back. So now I'm going to sprinkle, I'm a little bit on the side here with the H, but you'll get the idea. I could take it off again and do it new, but for the technique, it's fine. So I'm going to sprinkle that glitter, tap it off. Now I can touch it here, sprinkle the rest. little bit here. Just scoop it up a little bit. Put the glitter back into the jar. And again, that's fine. Put a little bit into the jar. And then I'm going to polish it. And I polish with a circular motion, because if you do a circular motion, I think you get the nicest coverage. So just do a and you see the sparkle coming out, and you see I'm too close to the edge here, but that's fine. Here, and you see clearly, I don't know if you can see, but like here I didn't polish yet, and here I did. So you clearly see the sparkle coming out when you polish. And I can trim it at the end, make it a little bit smaller if I want to. So polish the whole thing. And then I'm going to take my Swiffer to clean up the last little bits of the glitter. And I can also brush it, but when it's a little bit, I just use a Swiffer. And now I'm going to make sure because I'm going to use the diamond, so make sure there's no glitter left in my coffee filter. Then I'm going to take this off carefully, because I want to reuse this. So I'm going to save this. So just wiggle it a little bit. Make sure it stays in one piece. You see with the Y here, I need to be a little bit more careful. There you go, and here with the Y again. Just going to go around here. You see, so I can use this part for the same technique over and over and over again. So now I have my happy birthday. Then in this case, I'm going to take my cool diamonds, sprinkle that. And because it's a diamond, I'm going to tap it off, but not brush it off over my coffee filter, because I don't want any specks of the teal in my diamond. So especially with the diamond and the white, you want to be careful that you don't get any color in there. So close this. And then I can brush it off over a paper bag as well, but in this case, for the video, I'm just going to brush it off here. And then I'm going to polish this one. And then I have the part that I can trim and make a second card. So thank you for watching. I hope you like it. And you really need to try this, because it's fun. Don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel.